final stand begins. The final stand begins today.
What do you mean by that?
Meaning, it's either, well, who knows what's going to happen today. Meaning, hopefully Byron will make it out alive, or Larson, or Blaney. But even if Bell wins, I wouldn't really be upset. Yeah. I'll try to... Ow!
Got a little slight chip to it.
Oof. Still looks fine to me. It survived, luckily. That's what matters.
Yeah.
Man, oh man. I guess, not trying to like sugarcoat your accent or anything, but I guess the only good that came out of it is that it made me feel better about the accidents I was in before that one. Because now knowing that the damage I was involved in wasn't as terrifying.
Because from what I've seen on your end, yeah, like...
It was just traded pain.
What you went through, yeah, was not anything like what happened to me.
I guess...
Because like for me, like it was... A head-on collision where I was going like 40 to 45 to a complete stop.
Yeah, that is always scary for a civilian vehicle.
I was just damn lucky to have come out of that with just a bruise and a couple scratches on my arm.
I thankfully feel like I've moved on from my incidences. Sometimes my brain will replay here and there, but it's not like I will feel upset or anything. Because they're not ongoing. That's a nice park.
Thank you. last race for Kevin Harvick. Here's his radio.
Hey, Dad. I'm so proud of you. You've had a great career. Finish it off with one more.
Good for, buddy. Thank you.
Good luck, Dad.
Thank you, Piper.
Keelan and Piper saying, Dad, good luck on your last race. It's time to find out who the champion of 2023 will be. William Byron, Martin Truex Jr. Green flag is in the air. Group 1 and 2 clean. And now the fight for second is over. Harvick on the inside. Martin Truex Jr. on the outside.
Just wanted to know what he had in his race car. He's getting that right away as he makes a dive onto the flat, three wide for second.
Into turn one. He's trying to hug that yellow line. Up the racetrack he goes. That makes Harvick have to go up a little bit higher than he wanted to.
Ryan Larson talked about that car being loose in practice on entry. Probably a little bit nervous about getting that car into the corner underneath the board for the first time. Learning about how this car can handle how much grip it has. They're doing that right now.
It's door to door for second. Larson trying to take it away from Harvick. Harvick holding on to it right now.
Yeah, you can see right now the racetrack is ready in that second lane. A lot of times this racetrack is too dirty to run up the high line, but right now it's ready to roll. Kyle Busch right alongside Blaney will actually beat him down the front straightaway. Carry a little more speed. It makes Blaney have to actually overdrive the corner, try to slide up in front of Busch. That's exactly what he did.
Get it. stage one, Byron gets that round. Yeah, Byron gets that round. So far, so good.
Thank you.
way!
running pretty neutral lap times in the 41 of Priest had driven by. Now he's found something in this car. He's passing this 45 car, Reddick, already passed the 54 Ty Gibbs. He sees that he's competitive to this 24. He's matching lap times with the leaders. He's at one of his best racetracks. So he's gaining confidence in a season where they've not had a lot to be confident about. He is gaining confidence in this race car, and we'll start to consider, like, what really could happen today. This might be a race where they could go out there and contend for the win. Looking over to the leaderboard, you'll see that Bubba Wallace has made his way around Kyle Larson for third position. Let's take a look at that replay. I saw the lap time on the five, very, very slow. Here he is way up the racetrack. 23 to the inside, down the front straightaway. Bubba Wallace had good speed. He's matching the leaders. Down into turns one and two. Five car still at the top of the racetrack. Bubba's going to clear him right here.
As now the five under attack from the one of Ross Chastain. These two have had an eventful year. You mentioned Denny Hamlin and Ross Chastain. Well, Kyle Larson and Ross Chastain as well, all the way back to Darlington.
Everybody is slipping and sliding. Nobody has their car driving the way they want it to be. That's right up Kevin Harvick's alley. That's where he's been so good his entire career. Places where it gets slick. Car slides around a lot. Tires wear out. The lap car is up in the top groove in front of the 24. That takes away a little grip. In three and four, Byron pulls back ahead down the front straightaway.
Now the final lap of stage one. And Harvick
again
hugging that yellow line.
Again to the top of the racetrack, Rick. That lap traffic's giving it, making it a little difficult on the 24, but he clears again.
It's Todd Gilliland just in front of the 24. Both go down to the yellow line through three and four. And William Byron is going to come out of four, and he will win stage one. Ross Chastain, big fight there at the end as Harvick gets second, but Chastain right on his back bumper. Take a look at this. It's three wide, and Cindric almost sliding into the door of Larson.
Yeah, there were two cars on the outside of Larson that had been battling for the free pass. J.J. Yaley actually beat Cindric back to the line to be able to get the free pass, and I believe those two were.
Thank you.
final couple corners.
Another great restart. It's the one now of Ross Chastain fighting for the second spot with Harvick. Tucks in behind him as they go into turn three.
See a big wiggle, a big aggressive move out of the 20 of Christopher Bell. Ryan Blaney gained a couple on pit road, and here he is inside the top 10. Bell as well with the pit cycle running eighth.
Thank you.
Actually left a little rubber on the racetrack.
The car almost spun to the right when he makes this move. The car almost spins to the right. Very reminiscent of how cars drove and down the back straightaway at Rockingham and worn out racetracks. But look at him. He had to live about wrecked that race car right there. And I bet that surprised him.
And that sort of theme has consisted throughout this race in telling them about the four and where he is running. As you referenced now, once the four went by, they went to the top. Ooh, tight battle here, guys.
Yeah, the 12 of Ryan Blaney has really looked like you've been shot out of a rocket here. It's unbelievable what he just did. He went from being about a second behind these two to going right by them three wide. And so Blaney now has the advantage over the other two.
All good here. One lap at a time.
This may have been what he was talking about. The frustrations coming out of the radio for Blaney.
This is what we've seen lately from this guy. He has had good long run speed the last 2 weeks. He's got it again today.
But he just can't clear that 24 right now. Both of them running very high.
That's what makes this racetrack amazing. On old tires, drivers running different lines, especially using that high line at this racetrack. Now I think the 12's in a great spot. It's going to drive up the racetrack. Nothing Byron can do about that.
And the first of the championship four to be eliminated is going to be Christopher Bell. As he got into the wall, he's been talking about brake problems.
Explodes. Man, it looks like it's a flat because in the end it is a flat tire. The rotor goes through the wheel, the tire goes down, the 20th Christopher Bell has no option into the wall. We heard him complaining about brakes. The radio you heard was the crew chief coming back saying, hey, it's all on you. There's no more cooling available. And you see right here parts and pieces of the brakes coming off.
During that pit stop, Blaney did not have a good stop. Problem on the left front, went from third to seventh.
2x2 once again. Harvick and Chastain up front. Byron, the furthest forward of the championship four, running in the fourth position now. You see him fighting to the inside here for that second spot.
What a mess it is back there in row five and on back. Four wide, five wide, six wide. Insane. And the restarts just get crazier as the race goes on with more on the line. Oh, contact right there to 44. Priest is up the track. His teammate, Briscoe, gets into his left rear quarter panel.
How are they going to blend in with all these cars? It's going to be difficult in turn three. Making it out of there. Now they're going to go into turn one. See how this works out. Four wide.
Issues right here with the two. Looks like the two of Cedric has made contact with the right rear.
Right rear wall, or the wheel looks like it's about to come off on this too.
I think he's got a broken toe link, or the tire itself is trying to come off. Look at the contact there with the right rear. Let's see here. He's sideways coming to the start-finish line off turn four. Contact with the right rear. More contact right there.
Just trying real hard. You know, he struggled today. He did not have the speed. It's been a frustrating year. Just trying to make something happen, and back in the car, came around, smacked the wall, damage.
It gets to the door of the 24. Bonato to complete the pass as they go through the dog leg and down into turn one. Now he clears him.
Byron lets him take that position down into the corner. And now the championship three or fifth, sixth, and seventh.
We just saw Cindric get into the wall and break a right rear toe link. Well, this is the 22. Kind of straight up into the wall. That's the entry into one, the flat end of the racetrack. Pretty hard contact. And
Larson's not doing anything wrong. Larson is running the bottom of the racetrack. Now Blaney trying to get to the outside here. He's finally going to get there now. He's got great momentum down the front straightaway. In position to finally make this pass happen.
Larson fighting back on the inside.
Blaney has him where he wants. He wants him now, though. Going to beat him on corner exit pretty easily.
He actually kind of washed up on corner exit, had to lift. Thought he was going to beat him as well pretty easily, but both cars kind of struggled on that exit there. But so he's still right here on the outside, struggling to finish this off. He's like, man, I just got to get one good corner, and he's had two bad ones, allowing this five to hang around.
Tries it again. And again, Blaney probably has heard, maybe not, but two of his teammates, Austin Cindric and Logano, both had gotten into the wall.
Yeah, I would be surprised if they gave him that information, Rick, but, you know, just to let you know, I think, you know, you would assume. He talked about how loose his car was when we watched the battle for second place. Buescher going around the four of Harvick. And just momentarily in the screen there is the one of Chastain, not too far ahead of these two.
Buescher has been able to take over the top spot from Ross Chastain.
And down in the corner here, Gillen, the lap car, is going to go in the middle of the racetrack. It's going to run the one a little wider than I think he wanted to run. That's going to give some momentum to the 17. They battle down the front straightaway. Buescher eventually taking the spot. And I wondered about this as he was driving through the field in stage one. If this guy goes up and takes the lead, think about all the what ifs, right? See Byron getting by the 19, a Truex. And I see a little difference as well in that 12 car. Just doesn't have the speed on the long run that he had earlier. Byron, though, on the other hand, lost a little ground to the top four, got passed by this 19 car earlier in the run, but now has ran him back down, got back by him, and he's driving away, or at least keeping this 12 at bay. That's got to build confidence behind the wheel of the 24.
But William Byron is saying the same thing. Oh. Either one is as good as they need to be. Blaney out of control on corner exit.
You can just see the body language in how he's driving, the frustration over how this car drives. And he's still literally beating on the legboard of the seat because he can't do what he wants to do, and the car just won't produce the way he wants it to produce in the corner.
So Buescher has been impressive out front for 14 laps of this stage once he was able to get by Ross Chastain, looking for his second stage win this season. And as he comes out of four, it's Chris Buescher that wins stage two. The final stage is underway of championship weekend. Ross Chastain leading the race. And right now, the 24 of William Byron leading the championship fight. Byron going on the outside of the 19, trying to stay in second in front of Martin Truex Jr. He has the momentum, but he can't quite clear him as they go into three.
Blaney picks off the spot from the five of Larson in one and two. Larson battling back on the outside here. Larson lined up in the inside line where the control car of Chastain was, and it gave him that advantage on the launch to be able to beat the five through turns one and two.
Blaney has found something in this 12 car as he's been able to clear now William Byron, and he takes that spot away.
Yeah, the last handful of laps, this 12 car woke up, drove around the 19, a Truex, and now drives up to the back bumper and around the 24 into second place. He was talking about how he didn't love the car the last run, needed to make some changes. They had heard everything. Looks like to me they've actually improved this car over what we've seen all day long. Car really didn't have a ton of short run speed, really good long run speed, but here we are firing off well, Kim.
He's trying to pass the one of Chastain. Right now it's what can the 24 and the 5 do to counteract the 12, right? They're in fourth and fifth, which seems good, but track position-wise, they're over 3 seconds behind the 12 car. So with 81 to go, you're inside your fuel window. What a masterful job by Blaney. Not over driving the corner and just...
Not happy.
How you doing?
Not happy. We didn't even need to hear the radio on that one. As now he's down on the apron, trying to make the pass on the one. Door to door as they come out of the turn. Inches apart for the lead here at Phoenix.
This traffic right in front of them, Rick, could play a part. It's going to slow one of the cars down, be a disadvantage to one of the cars as they're side by side down the front straightaway.
Blaney. I feel like this is where Blaney has an advantage, though. He rolls the bottom so well.
I just feel like that 51 of Newman is going to play a role in this one way or another. Going to dive out of the way there, try to allow these guys to race it out.
Blaney to the bottom again. Chastain keeping the momentum up as he runs that higher line, and Blaney just can't stay on that left rear quarter panel. Has to get out of the gas a bit.
Wow, that was close.
Now look who's here.
Yeah. Oh, Blaney.
Blaney into the back of the one. Here comes the 19. Martin Truex Jr. three wide for the lead. Chastain shooting back out in front, but Blaney now on the bottom of the racetrack, getting aggravated.
Be smart here, Ben. Be smart.
All right. Blaney's got a pretty good position on him in this corner.
Be smart here, Ben. Be smart.
Spotter letting him know. Big picture. Be smart. Blaney's in front. He takes the lead away from Chastain.
Chastain trying to get back underneath him, though.
I don't get me smart with him. Inside corner. Inside.
And Martin Truex Jr. might be the faster car of the three as he's closed the gap now.
Almost contact for the 12 into the outside wall off of four.
51 laps remaining in the season and this championship hunt.
That 19 right there is bothering that 12 just a little bit on entry there.
Whoa, Blaney way loose.
Big wobble.
Gotta be smart here.
By half a tenth.
Keep in the hunt. The 12 is melting down. Stay in the freaking hunt. He's only two ahead of you.
My man Rudy Fugel is scanning and he is selling. And I love it. The 12 is melting down. You know him. He can imagine it. I like that's a motivational radio right there. You can hear the excitement. Look at him. That is a red-faced, fired-up Rudy Fugel.
For the lead, Blaney now. Almost contact with Chastain. Chastain.
Caution
has come out right in front of these drivers as they go into turn three. It's at the start-finish line. And we see the eight of Kyle Busch has spun around. That brings the caution out. And now, once again, these pit crews are going to have to go to work to try to keep this track position and potentially help their driver get out in front.
He said he's too free on entry. There's a drag race off pit road, and we'll see if Larson was able to gain any spots over the 12. But look at that, Blaney holding serve in fifth.
Green flag back in the air. Now just 31 laps to go.
Larson did not get a good launch.
Rewind for second. Larson way down on the apron. Here comes the one of Chastain. Momentum on the outside. Now, the 11 of Hamlin fighting back.
Blaney on the outside of Byron back there takes that spot away. He's in a pretty good position right here. The 5 gets off this corner low and bottled up. Larson's got to clear these two guys. If not, they're going to be right on him behind from behind.
Larson up the racetrack. Slides up in front of the 11. The one way up against the wall. Larson trying to take the lead away.
Blaney had to lift right there. 24 takes that spot back away. Byron.
Larson can't clear the one, but he's in front of the other two GM4 contenders. Now a big run by the 12 of Blaney. He tries to go to the high side as the 24 of Byron way down cutting the dog leg.
Blaney countered it, though, with a lot of entry speed to stay alongside him. Byron did a great job of shortcutting the front stretch. But Blaney, that's a good move. Oh, he's trying to block, trying to cut down on that 24 on entry.
He's going to stay higher than Larson as Larson ducked back to that yellow line. Trips up the racetrack right in front of the Blaney gets a little loose.
Larson big loose right there. Now Blaney to the outside. Larson slides up the racetrack, trying to take the line away.
For the championship. Now less than 21 laps to go.
Contact right there. Jump on the right rear quarter panel as well. Try to take that line away. Larson a little bit quicker, half a tenth quicker that last lap.
Now 9 to go.
With
winding down. Larson's got to put a push together right now.
And you have to believe, to your point, Jeff Burton, that 12 car of Blaney has backed it off just a touch. With only 2 corners left.
1.4 seconds separating 1 and 2. And about the same separating Blaney.
Is what it is. At least I now have history of seeing Blaney win a championship.
Yep.
Let's just be thankful it wasn't Logano winning the fourth time in a row for you.
Uh-huh.
The race is
going. Ow. Yeah.
You can find.
Why not?
Because this car truly has a big trunk.
Care that you're driving.
Pretty sure that the 91 Caprice can hold more than the luxury car you own today, because the Caprice has no less than 20.4 cubic feet of trunk space. Now that's not only bigger than any BMW, Jaguar, or Lexus, but it's enough for 18 bags of groceries. The Caprice is full of practical details, too.
And I can live with.
Like this trunk convenience net to stop things from sliding around. Now, it's not until you look really close up that you see why the new Caprice's paint looks so good. It has a clear coat paint finish, which produces a lasting glossy look its rivals would be pleased to match. And on this car, beauty is more than skin deep. You know the damage a car can sustain in parking lots? Well, the Caprice doors and side panels are designed to be protected from those little scratches and scrapes. It has two-sided galvanized sheet steel to resist the rust that can start right here. The new Caprice is more than just a good-looking car. This stylish shape has been wind tunnel tested for aerodynamic efficiency.